Hallo Leute, welcome back to a new video. My name is Steffi and today I will show you some cool examples on how literal German actually is. Some of them might sound silly to you, but I assure you they are very logical. But before we start, I want to quickly share with you a great opportunity on how to learn German this summer and get the chance of a 100% cashback, which I actually participate myself. As you know, summer is a bit different this year, but so do something different to match. You can be able at the end of summer to speak confidently in German. I partnered up with Lingoda because I know they're very experienced in what they do. More than 30,000 students have already participated and many of them have succeeded. They got new job opportunities and also overcame the fear of speaking in a foreign language. I have tried Lingoda, I took lessons myself, and now I participate in the Super Sprint in Spanish. Finally, I will learn Spanish. I was planning it for a long time already and now I'm gonna do it. Vamos, vamos! So how does it work? You will learn with qualified and native speaking teachers. You can book the lessons at any time, any day, and you will speak more in German. As an average, you will just have 3 other students in the group class. For each lesson, you get some learning materials provided and structured courses. And you can choose between the Super Sprint and the Normal Sprint. I chose the Super Sprint. Besides German, you can also learn English, French, Spanish, and Business English. And the sprints are available for all levels. You have to sign up before June 15 and pay a deposit of 49 euros to secure your spot. With this code you will save 10 euros and you can use the link in the description to get there. Yeah, and then just attend to the agreed amount of classes to get all your money back. And be fast because the places are limited. Lingoda challenges have been running for more than 2 years already and it's a proven concept. Many students have shared their stories. If you want to read some of them, check out their Instagram account. But let's learn how literal German actually is. Los geht's! German is a so-called Lego language. It means you can take one word and another word, you put them together and you get a completely new meaning. For example, in this one. You just take a wire, put it together with a donkey and you get a bicycle. Can you see it? Because a Drahtesel is not the official name for a bicycle, this is a Fahrrad, you might know, but it's a nickname for it. This word is Handschuhe. It means hand shoes. I mean, come on, why inventing a completely new word if you already have one and then you just put it here, right? What are shoes anyways? This one is a Klobrille. Can you guess what it is? The literal translation is toilet glasses. No idea? Well, it's a toilet seat. There are also many words in German that ends with Zeug. Zeug means thing. And I guess it fits to everything. This one is a Flugzeug. It's literally a flying thing. It's an airplane. Schlagzeug. A hitting thing. Drums. Spielzeug. A playing thing? What can it be, right? Ah yeah, it's a toy. Let's take a thing that we can drive in. It must be a driving thing. Yes, let's name it Fahrzeug. A vehicle. German is also very literal if it's about the names of animal. They like to name the animal after their characteristic plus animal. So let's get to know some. Das Haustier. A Haustier is a house animal. It's a pet. A Stinktier. A stink animal. Yes, obviously, that's a skunk. But do you know what a lazy animal is? A lazy animal, das Faultier in German, is a sloth. The Gürteltier is a belt animal. And in English you would call it an armadillo. I have no clue how to pronounce this. Please someone teach me. And the Schnabeltier, the beak animal, is named after its most characteristic, the beak. And it is a ta-da-ta-ta, platypus, or however you name it. Other very literal names are die Nacktschnecke, a naked snake, is a slug. Der Durchfall, the through fall, It's diarrhea, my friends. And the last one for today is Sehenswürdigkeiten. It means something that's worthy to see. It's a sight. And that was it for today. Thank you so much for watching. The next one is coming up on Wednesday. And yes, have a great week. Macht's gut. Auf Wiedersehen. Tschüss.